Hello my dear friends, welcome to the Java programming playlist. In the previous video, we have seen the loop instruction in Java and the types of loop that are available in Java. We know that there are three types of loop: while loop, do while loop and for loop. In that video, we have discussed on while loop. Now in this video, we are going to discuss on the do while loop that is there in Java programming. Let us start understanding the do while loop. Do while loop is similar to while loop, except for the fact that it is guaranteed to execute at least once. The while loop is entry controlled loop, while the do while loop is an exit control loop. So it is guaranteed that it will execute the code which is inside the loop at least once. And then it will check for the condition, and then depending on the condition whether it is true or false, it will decide to whether continue the loop or exit from the loop. Use a do while loop when the exact number of iterations are unknown, just like while loop, but you need to execute the code block at least once. So you want to execute the code block at least once because you want something to happen, and then you want to check the condition. In such scenario, you have to use the do while loop. After executing part of the program, for once, the rest of the code gets executed on the basis of the mentioned Boolean condition. Here is the syntax of the do while loop. Do, the code inside the loop, and then while the condition. Note this semicolon. So this semicolon is very important in the case of do while loop. If you don't write the semicolon, the compiler will not be able to understand where your loop conditions are terminating or the loop conditions are getting over. So here, while entering into the loop, the code will be executed and then the while condition is checked. Hence it is called the exit control loop. What is the difference between while loop and do while loop? So while loop checks the condition and executes the code. This we have seen in the previous video, that while loop, first the condition is checked and then it enters into the loop part. But in the case of do while loop, it executes the code at least once and then checks for the condition. Because of this reason, the code in the do while loop execute at least once, even if the condition fails, even if this condition is false, but the loop will be executed once, and when the condition is false, it will come out of the loop, but there will be the execution at least once. Now let us understand the do while loop with the flow control structure. So here is this flow control structure of do while loop. First, it enters into the code inside the body of the loop. So it does all these things at least once. Then it goes and checks for the condition. When the condition is true, it will again go into the loop and do whatever the statements are written. Then it checks for the condition, and if it is true, it will again do the same activity. But when the condition becomes false, it exits from the loop. Hence it is called exit control loop. Let us look at the example of do while loop. So here is this example, public static void main. We have initialized the value of v as 1. Then do system.out.println b. So it will print 1, then b++. So b value will become 2. And then it will check for the condition. B is less than 5, that is 2 is less than 5, yes. So it will go again and print the value of B. So it will print the value of 2. So let us see the output. So output here is 1, 2, 3, 4. So this will continue 4 times. And after the value of B is 4, that is printed here, the B++ will make this value 5. It will check this, 5 is less than 5. No, the condition is false and it will exit from the loop. Hence in this do while loop, the output here will be 1 2 3 4, and on the condition where the b value becomes 5, it exits from the loop. So I hope this is very much clear, my dear friends. In the next video, we are going to see the for loop, and that will complete all the types of loop available in Java. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned for more videos on Java programming.